nothing!
Lossless scaling. What is it and why does every gamer need it? Lossless scaling, or LS, is a Steam app developed by THS that adds upscaling to any game. It has 9 different upscaling algorithms to choose from, including AMD FSR and even their own AI upscaler. This year, they also added LSFG for frame generation. Together, these features are extremely useful, not only for gamers with low-powered specs, like say an ROG Ally or older GPUs, but also anyone with a high frame rate monitor. It's become all too common to boot up a shiny new game only to realize you have to start cutting back visual settings, and probably turn off ray tracing if you hope to hit your monitor's refresh rate. With lossless scaling, the joke of downloading more FPS really has become a reality. Now let's get right into those features. After installation, you'll see scaling mode, scaling type, and frame generation. Scaling mode you can leave on auto. LS will need you to set your game to either windowed or full screen windowed to work properly. If your game is running in full screen, it won't work, causing bugs with frame rate and black screen. This is because it's designed to take a windowed game and make it full screen. So with your game window open, you can easily apply your settings by using the hotkey Ctrl+Alt+S. As for scaling type, this is where you can choose how you want LS to upscale your game. The developer THS recommends anime 4K for visual novels and either FSR, NVIDIA Image Scaling NIS, or their own LS1 for modern games. FSR and NIS are both similar spatial upscaling algorithms.
I'll check it out.
I've found that you can get a very sharp look from NIS, but FSR is slightly superior because it applies better anti-aliasing to edges. LS1 is a machine learning upscaler created by THS. It uses a general-purpose AI neural network to achieve better results when compared to FSR, but at a slightly higher performance cost. It's still a spatial upscaler without access to motion vector data, so it's not going to be on the same level as DLSS. LS1 is designed to either double the base resolution or provide cheap supersampling compared to running a game at 2x the resolution and downsampling. Choosing between these 3 upscaling solutions will depend on your hardware and what render scale you're using, so try using LS1, and if you're still having trouble hitting your framerate target, then swap it for FSR or NIS. Last January, THS announced lossless scaling frame generation, or LSFG, for doubling 60fps games up to 120. In May, they released LSFG 2.0. This gave us a big improvement in quality by reducing ghosting artifacts around UI and HUD elements, as well as much better motion handling, making it possible to play 30fps games at 60. Finally, the most publicized improvement came on June 6th. LSFG 2.1 was released with the ability to now triple the FPS of games. It also has a performance mode for less powerful GPUs, and improved performance of X2 mode by 20%. What nobody seems to have noticed is the third improvement they mentioned here. Lossless scaling no longer needs to be locked to a multiple of your monitor's refresh rate. Previously, if you wanted to hit 120fps and your game was running at, say, 80, you would need to lock it to 60 and let LS double the frame rate. Now, with the 2.1 update, your game can run at any arbitrary frame rate. The lossless scaling app will only increase the frame rate up to your monitor's refresh rate and won't go past it, saving on resources and ensuring there isn't screen tearing. If, however, your game's base frame rate is fluctuating wildly, you can still lock it down to a stable lower frame rate, or you can choose to turn on Allow Screen Tearing. This reduces the latency to the lowest possible, but as the name implies, it will show any screen tearing that may occur. So how does this look in action? Well, unfortunately, I don't have a good way of capturing high frame rate, plus YouTube won't display anything higher than 60. So here's what I'll do. In the top left corner, I have cap frame X displaying FPS, frame time, and other stats. This shows us what frame rate the game is rendering at. In the top right corner, I have NVIDIA's in-game overlay tracking the final frame rate sent from the lossless scaling app to my monitor. With LSFG set to 3x, I'm able to take the internal render of about 60 to 70 FPS, triple it, and now I'm easily hitting my monitor's max refresh rate of 165. This is the best scenario you can use, doubling or tripling a frame rate at or above 60 FPS. This will give you great image quality with fewer motion artifacts and very low latency. If you're starting at lower frame rates though, artifacts and latency will increase. THS suggests not going any lower than 40 FPS for 1440p or 30 FPS for 1080p. At these frame rates, you will notice motion artifacts. Here's an example. At 1080p, I used the NVIDIA control panel to lock the frame rate at 30, so that's what the in-game overlay is reporting in the top right. In the top left, 60 FPS is the frame rate lossless scaling is reporting when frame gen is on. The latency, of course, is not as good compared to native 60, however, it doesn't feel too bad when using a controller. The motion artifacts are also not that bad when in motion, so I'll slow down the footage so you can more easily see it. So there you have it. That's my overview of the Lossless Scaling app. I plan on doing a more in-depth video on the upscaling options at different resolutions, so make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that. Give the video a like and let me know what else you'd like me to test. A big thanks to my super subscriber Jordan for helping make this video possible. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.